because it's after this year's event that we say farewell and happy retirement to the event's chief executive, Tim Prince. In 1971, a new event called the Air Factory was founded at North Wheels in Essex. It was organised by a new team of volunteers, one of whom was a young air traffic controller named Tim Prince. But so grew, moving to IAS Freedom Common and then to IAS Fairford, Tim and his late friend and colleague Paul Bowen sent him into the world's greatest military air show. As the show's co-director with Paul, and then Paul's death in 2004 as chief executive, Tim has continued to steer the show with deep enthusiasm. The volunteer team back to the West Colleges is crucial to its safety. So not just the this show, but the whole show team is considerable. We've always been a great supporter of the entire air traffic industry. And through the attitude, its contribution also to many affiliates of the airplane world has been considerable also. One thing for example of the likes of Ian Seeley and Dave Walton, who now organise air displays across the country. Jan Fraser, the flying display director of Stratford, was a volunteer in the late 1970s. He told me, being a small part of the air tattoo contributed to my experience. As our flying control committee chairman Roger Beasley said, Tim is a very challenging chap to work with, and that's why those 4 degrees made it count the support of such a large volunteer team. Well, today is nothing short of the end of the year. Tim retired as chief executive. Remember, Henry Armstrong has been preparing to take up the baton and give you after a show. We will have to thank all of today's excellent flight to Tim and will incorporate our appreciation for his part in the success of the air.